Good morning, everyone. Stephen Whiteside here with a quick look at the North American stock markets for Friday morning. Well, the markets have opened and both the Dow and the TSX are up about 140 points. Apparently, the catalyst for this buying this morning is a sharp move up in the price of crude oil. So crude oil and the markets moving higher on Friday morning. Now, this is a very quick presentation, not a lot to talk about this morning. The S&P 500 cash index actually generated a sell signal yesterday, closing just below the lower channel line. What didn't happen is we didn't see a corresponding sell signal in the SPDR ETF or the leveraged ETFs that I trade. And so still waiting for a sell signal. We were closed 1 cent above the lower channel line. So got very, very close to generating a sell signal there. And of course, after the sell signal in the bull ETF, we'd want to take a buy signal in the bear ETF. And that didn't happen yesterday, so nothing to do on Friday morning. Now, the VIX for the S&P 500 has moved up over the past couple of days, made a higher high yesterday. And so we've been on a buy signal since Tuesday and then waiting for buy signals in the corresponding ETFs. And we actually generated buy signals yesterday, so closed above the upper channel line for the three major VIX ETFs that I follow. And what I wanted to just caution people about these ETFs is they are extremely volatile. And of course, that's funny because you're following the volatility index. And so, of course, you would expect them to be volatile. When you look at the rest of the market, they are basically, it's much like trading natural gas. When you buy it, you're actually pulling the pin on a hand grenade, and the volatility is at the very edge of what investors see in the stock market trading major stocks. If we look at the overall stock market just as a benchmark, if you look at the average true range, and if you were to stop me on the street and ask me on any day without looking at a chart, I'd tell you that the average true range for the stock market, both the TSX and the S&P 500, is about 1% per day. And so the difference between the high and the low of the day is usually about 1%. Now, right now, we're coming off a major spike in volatility back in January and February, where the market moved down sharply, found a bottom, bounced, came back down, retested that bottom, and then started to move up. And so we had a lot of volatility back there, but on average, it's about 1%. And so then you find if you go to financial stocks, you're going to be around that 1% or a little higher, insurance stocks. And then as you start to move out and start taking on more risk, when you get into biotechs and pharmaceuticals, when you get into manufacturing stocks, and then start to move out towards the resources, the stocks, the mining stocks, the energy explorers, the volatility starts to increase and increase. And what you see at the very edge of the end of the scale is the volatility indexes themselves. And so if you look here, you can see the VIX, this is the VIX index itself for the S&P 500, is nearly 9% right now, the difference between the high and the low per day. And then if we look at the ETFs on those, we're up at 10%. And if you look at the Horizon Beta Pro product, it's just below 10% per day. So that is not a normal instrument that the average investor looks at and trades per day. If you're looking at your portfolio moving up or down 10% per day, that is right at the extreme edge of risk. And most people don't need that much risk in their portfolio. Now, typically, you only see that type of volatility in a penny stock. And so here's a 18-cent gold stock with a volatility of 11% per day, an average true range of 11% per day. That's typically where you see that type of volatility. So just be aware of that when you're trading the VIX ETFs. If you're using our charts and you're going to follow the rules and get out when you're supposed to get out and get in when you're supposed to get in, then over time you're going to do very well, but it's not something that you just want to buy and leave sitting around for any length of time. Okay, let's move on. And the NASDAQ did not generate a sell signal yesterday. And one of the reasons there's more weakness in the S&P 500, of course, is bank stocks, and they were down sharply yesterday. Bank of America still on a sell signal, but the big one is Deutsche Bank right now. And here's a bank, and again, this is a major global bank, big German bank, down over 25% in the last 30 days. And so that's a huge move for a bank. So speaking about volatility, here's a bank that has huge volatility right now, which is certainly out of character with the rest of the banking sector. Transports were also lower yesterday, so we still have a sell signal in the transports, and they could be one of the catalysts to lead this market lower, but certainly not on Friday morning. Let's take a quick look at our commodity tracking ETFs. Inside day yesterday for the commodity tracking ETF, inside yesterday for crude oil. Now, crude oil, last time I looked, was up at 995 up here, so that would certainly generate a buy signal on Friday. Inside day yesterday for gasoline, natural gas still holding around the channel line, really not breaking away from the channel at all, so we're flip-flopping back and forth here. The pros are still in control, but the problem with natural gas is we're still trying to get over the 50-day moving average, and we have not been able to do that so far. The base metal ETF, tracking ETF, was down sharply yesterday. That has a lot to do with the price of copper. Gold was up yesterday, so we're back on a buy signal there. It's a high-risk buy signal, but you've got a pressure zone there. I thought we would have probably made it down to test this open gap here down at the 112 level and change, the 112.50 level. You can see that we went up to 118.75 yesterday, closed just above that by a few cents. 121.88 is our next target, and then 125, that's our playing field right now if you want to take the buy signal there. Of course, a close above below 116.68 on Friday would give us a sell signal if that were to happen. So far, that doesn't look like it's going to happen. We had platinum trade up to the upper channel line yesterday, no buy signal. Silver traded up to the upper channel line yesterday, no buy signal there. We need a close on Friday for the SLV above $14.59. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation, and that's all for me for this week. Just looking over my shoulder, I see the markets have come off their morning highs, but have not given up that much. There's nothing wrong with trading the VIX ETFs at all. They are extremely volatile, and so they should not make up a large percentage of anyone's portfolio. Of course, there are parts of everyone's portfolio where you can have a little fun, but don't overdo it with the VIX ETFs. Have a great day, folks, and we'll talk to you again next on Monday morning.